Hello friends, happy Thursday. My name is Duke, and I've been neglecting the Binding of Isaac for a good long time now. But since I won't be able to stream tomorrow, I thought I would try to make it up to people, possibly, by jumping into some of these challenges. I will hopefully get back to Castle in the Darkness on Sunday, but tomorrow and Saturday aren't going to be good, so hence this sort of impromptu stream. And hopefully my audio sounds a little bit better than last time. I noticed my mic was sort of clipping in the last video, in the last stream. It was kind of hot, so, you know, like a hot mic, not like warm. But hopefully I got the balance right for this time. If it's not right, then hopefully someone can let me know. So anyway, I've not done any of these challenges yet. I've been saving them all for the stream. In my free time, in my non-streaming time, I've been working on beating every boss on hard, which over on the left-hand side you can get an idea of my progress. Beating every boss with every character. Only done the boss run with Azazel, or Azazel. I don't know how I'm going to be able to do that with any of the other characters. It's going to be extremely difficult, especially if I try to do it on hard. Somehow I managed to beat all of them on hard with Judas, which I must have got really lucky, because Judas is my least favorite character in the game. Also, with Isaac, I managed to beat all of the bosses on hard. But yeah, this isn't what we'll be focusing on today. Today we will be focusing on the challenges. And I guess the place I should start with is challenge number one, which is called Pitch Black, which is kind of a bummer because that probably means every level is going to be dark, and I really hate the dark levels. That's it's kind of a bummer of a first challenge, but I mean, it doesn't make sense not to start at challenge number one, so here we go. So I don't start with the D6 in the challenge run, which I believe that's how it worked in vanilla Binding of Isaac as well. Not sure what that symbol over there means. It's like a victory cup with a no symbol over. I guess that means I haven't completed the challenge yet. Not sure what else that could mean. Maybe it means this doesn't count as a victory for the purposes of unlocking things? Not entirely sure. I haven't played a little bit of this in my spare time in the past couple days, just to catch up on some podcasts. Because we've entered the slow time at work, or relatively slow, so I haven't had as much time to listen to podcasts at work. I mean, I've had the time, I've just, if there's no work to do, I'd rather be reading a book or something. This is a great podcast game. I recommend it for that. And it's a great streaming game. Is this music different? Sounds unfamiliar. I wonder if they composed different music for the challenges. That'd be pretty awesome. I really hate the Curse of Darkness. Like, when I'm playing normally, this is probably my least favorite curse to get out of any of them. But, I guess it kind of makes sense that this will be the first challenge, then. Sort of a trial by fire. And it's Bod's Rotten Head. Not a big fan of this item, but I have no way to re-roll, so I guess I'll go ahead and pick that up. I mean, it could be worse. There are definitely some items in Rebirth that I will not pick up under any circumstance. So I'm glad I didn't get one of those. Off the top of my head, I think it's the cursed eye, or the cursed eyeball, or something. It makes it so it replaces your attack with a really weak charge attack, and But, I mean, the charge attack isn't that bad, but the thing that really gets me about that item is that there's a chance of randomly teleporting every time you get hit. And, that makes the game incredibly unfun. Trade a bomb for a key, eh? Well, I don't have any keys, so I will probably come to appreciate that on the next level. Alright. Pretty non-threatening first boss to run into. The main reason I hate the Curse of Darkness is because it makes it really difficult for me to see these flies. Like, extremely difficult. Maybe they deliberately make the Duke of Flies the first boss just to make it as annoying as possible. Like that double fly there that I almost just ran into, I couldn't see that thing at all. Like, I was focusing my attention on what was in front of me, and the flies just don't stand out in the darkness as well as you want them to. Do I also have the Curse of the Unknown? I can't see my health. Is that going to be a constant thing in this challenge run as well? Because if so, aw man. So that's going to be a double bummer. No devil room. I don't think this does anything good. Luck up. Well, okay. Given my key star state, I guess that's a decent enough item to get early on. I do still have the Curse of the Unknown. That really sucks. Well, it's not also the Curse of the Blind, where you don't know what any of the items you're getting are. I'd say that's probably my other least favorite curse after the Curse of Darkness. Nothing worse than, because I mean, you have to just pick up every item you see, because it's not like I'm going to pass up items just because I don't know what they are. I can't pass up every item, so eventually I'm probably going to get something that I really don't like. Oh hey, what's up, Just Drop? If it's a challenge I'm thinking of, every floor is cursed. Well, that's been the case so far. I'm not sure if it's going to be the same curses every time or if it's going to mix it up. Do I want to use 2 keys on this? Yeah, that'll leave me with 1 key for the item room. I should be okay. Hey, the keys replaced themselves. Awesome. And I got a bunch of other loot. A bunch of other goodies. So yeah, Exergia got back to me about the subtitle script where I was including the chat log in my videos as subtitles, and Exergia does not have access to the computer with that script on it at the moment, and I'm not sure when I'm going to be able to implement that again. I mean, it should be a relatively simple script. I mean, I might be able to figure it out for myself. I mean, I'm not like a coder or anything, but I've done like speed up. Nah, let's keep the penny. I've done like look at someone else's code and change it to suit what I want it to do. I mean, it just has to search for text and replace it with other text basically, but in a way that automates the whole thing, so I don't have to go through and do it all manually. Which, I mean, I could do that, but that's a little too time-consuming. So, I don't know. I might be able to figure something out. If there's anyone else who's watching who has coding ability or experience or knows the first thing about it, wants to help out, then, you know, I'd appreciate it. Twitch IRC chat overlay text output. That sounds like what I need. I'll definitely check that out. Thank you, Just Trap. Oh, man. That's not a great item either. Crap. Well, on the plus side, if this is like Vanilla Binding of Isaac, with these early challenges, you only have to defeat... with the first challenge, I might only have to defeat Mom. I might not even have to go as far as It Lives, or Mom's Heart. And I don't think it's until the very late challenges that you have to go past It Lives. It opens it up as like a window in the stream itself. Oh, okay. Oh, yeah, that makes sense if it's an overlay. I could do that. I mean, that's probably a more elegant solution. But, you know, I like giving people the option of whether they want to read the chat log or not. I don't like having it there all the time. Although, with the Binding of Isaac, it would be pretty easy since I have all this blank space over on either side that I'm alluding to with my mouse cursor. It would be pretty easy. Stream is still screwed up. Well, Sarah, if you want, I'm actually testing out broadcasting on Twitch and Steam broadcasting at the same time. So if you want to try that to see if it completely breaks my computer, you can just, I think you can right-click my name and select Watch Game. Or if you go to my Steam profile and click on Watch Game, you can do it that way. That'd be interesting to test. If you want. If you don't want, then no worries. But yeah, I mean, I could just put the chat log, the chat right here. But again, you know, some people aren't interested in that, and I don't know. I know it's a mistake to try to please everybody, but I try to do it as often as possible. Now, where could the secret room be? There's no really obvious place. I'm thinking probably right here. I want to use... Yeah, I have 7 bombs. Well, yeah, I'll save Bob's Rotten Head for the boss. Hello, Bin-O-2-O. Bin-O. It's a shame I don't stream or make YouTube videos that often as I used to. Well, you know, recently I've just been busy at work, and I'm going to try to get back to streaming and doing videos as often as I used to. It's kind of hard to get back into the habit once you get used to not talking a whole lot. Trying to reacclimate yourself to talking a lot. I mean, I'm not a natural talker or anything, so. But I'm trying. I'd like to get back to doing twice a week again. That'd be pretty rad. 2 hours stream twice a week. That should be adequate. Of course, if the stream wasn't working for Sarah, then she probably didn't hear anything I just said. I wasn't sure if she meant the chat or the actual stream itself. It might have been the stream itself, in which case, you know, maybe next time. Crap. Wow, that's all the health I had? Do I maintain any contact with Mors Draconis? Yeah, he's my cousin. We hang out, you know, at least once a week. Been playing a lot of EU for the past couple days. That's one of those incredibly complicated strategy games, right? I have a lot of friends on Steam who have been playing a lot of Crusader Kings 2 recently, and so it's always kind of funny whenever I see a screenshot of that game, because to me, when someone posts a screenshot of Crusader Kings 2, it basically just looks like a map of Europe. Like, I look at it and I try to figure out what the, what, you know, why they posted that specific screenshot, that specific map of Europe, and it's not always very obvious. Wait, did I start with an item this time? I have that bomb thing. The Mr. Boom or whatever. That's weird. I wonder if you just start with a random item. If that's the case, it might be kind of like playing as Eden, except with the same stats every time. Or is that the item that I got from that? Oh, I bet I got that. I got it from that mini boss room. I just wasn't paying attention. Crusader Kings 2 is basically a map of Europe. Really? I thought Crusader Kings was like one of those grand X4 strategy games or whatever. 4X. Rubber tears, eh? Well. That's kind of useful. Yeah, I made a dumb joke on Twitter. I posted, it's my first playthrough of Crusader Kings 2. Man, this game's awesome. Here's a screenshot from my first playthrough, and I just posted a literal map of Europe. Which, I might be kind of a jerk move, but I was poking fun at my own, confusion there. And maybe kind of being a jerk. Got some iced tea here. Been making a ton of iced tea recently. It's great. It's way less expensive than like buying soda or something. And I put a lot less sugar in it than would be in soda normally. Still has some sugar, so it's not like a health drink or anything, but it's a pretty good alternative, I think. Just a dumb strategy game, not much insight into it is required. Well, that's a dumb strategy game. I'd hate to see a smart strategy game, because even the dumb ones completely confound me, apparently. But, you know, I'm not really a strategy game player. I'm more of an action game player. Not that every game I play has to have an action component. I mean, I do play, like, very strategic turn-based RPGs and stuff, but, anything that requires a lot of planning ahead, a lot of micromanaging, not really the kind of game for me. Unlike the Binding of Isaac, where I just kind of flail around, don't really plan ahead at all. Crap. Devil Room? Nope. Nope, no Devil Room. Not surprising since I got hit. I tried Civilization 5 at one point, and I really couldn't get into it. Just everything was just way over my head. Because, you know, I picked it up on a Steam sale for like $5, so I figured, well, maybe I actually like this kind of game, I just haven't played the right game yet. And I couldn't get into it. Yeah, it looks like I have the Curse of Darkness and the Curse of the Unknown on every single floor. Which is going to make this quite the ordeal. But, like I said, I think I'm just going to I only have to make it as far as Mom. Hopefully. If it's the same, if it works the same way it did in the original Binding of Isaac. Which, I mean, the original Binding of Isaac had a different challenge for challenge number one. I don't remember what it was. But, well, the original didn't even have the Curse of Darkness. So, you know, right out the gate, this is a completely different thing. I could just cheat and turn my screen brightness up. If I start sucking too badly, I might do that. Because, I mean, there's nothing fun about not being able to see what you're doing. This doesn't add anything to the game for me. Okay, what's up, Private Steve? Yeah, I haven't played Crusader Kings 2. I don't actually know anything about that game. I'm just talking out of my butt. Man, Bod's head again? You suck. I'll take it. I haven't even been using Mr. Boom. Actually, I should use Mr. Boom to check for check for a secret door right here. If I'm going to give it up anyway. It seems simplistic to you. Well, maybe you're just way smarter than me, Benno. But, I mean, I don't really know anything about the game except people posting screenshots that are just maps of Europe. Alright, I'm at full health, apparently. I don't know what my health is. I assume it's still 3. Trade a bomb for a key. Let's, test this wall and get that key in the process. Nope. Hello, still got a key. Oh god. Oh man, I couldn't see that thing. Crap. Double Monstro. Well, got his health down pretty low right off the bat with Bob's head there. Bob's head is pretty good against the earlier bosses, because that explosion damage and the poison right off the bat does a pretty good amount of damage. Oh, no double room. Man, if I didn't get hit by Monstro, I probably would have gotten one. Alright, I think there's one other obvious place I didn't test for secrets. So let's go do that real quick. Yeah, there we go. This is the worst secret room ever, because it's actually a net loss. A bomb is worth 5 coins, so I'm actually at minus 2 coins of total value for bombing into that room. Alright, see you later, Benno. Thanks for hanging out. Darkness and can't see health curse. Yeah, that seems to be the gist of this challenge, Private Steve. Unfortunately, because there are my two most hated curses in this game. Well, at least I made it to the catacombs this time. Got killed by freaking Haunt in the last run. Man, I haven't actually played this game with sound in a while. Usually listening to a podcast. Which you would think that being distracted like that would make me play more poorly. But it's actually not that distracting at all. I generally do pretty well, even when I'm listening to podcasts. It's when I'm talking at the same time that I play that I tend to screw up. So, you guys should just trust me when I say I'm really awesome, except when you're watching me play. Just keep that in mind as you watch me struggle my way through this challenge. I'm really awesome, except when you can see me. Also, when I get hit, it's totally the controller's fault. I have a girlfriend who lives in Canada. She goes to a different school. I make several tens of thousands of dollars a year, just not necessarily US dollars. No, when you do the conversion, it's quite an impressive number. Basically, I'm just awesome in a bunch of ways that you guys will never be able to see. Crap. Like, there, right, when I got hit by the maggot thing, that's actually part of my strategy. It's a very, little-known glitch in this game, where if you get hit by those things in just the right way, it does all kinds of awesome things. Cellar for me is always haunting. Yeah. Really like the music in the cellar. I like the music in this game overall. I don't know why people complain about it. And I know I've gone off on this rant before, but I think they just don't like it because it's different. Doesn't fit into their worldview. And don't get me wrong, I like the original soundtrack a lot too. But this soundtrack is really cool. It's like a dark, ambient, industrial kind of thing that I really dig. Oops, wrong button. Oh yeah, you can actually cancel Bob's head. It's one of the nice things about that item. I should probably bomb some of these mushroom clusters and see if I get any pills or other goodies. Trinkets. Because I think the drop rate, for pills especially, is pretty high. Liberty cap. Well, I haven't actually seen any flies spawn from this fish thing, which I think that's what it does. I think it causes flies to spawn. So I'll take the liberty cap. There's a pill. Pills here. Range down. Okay. So yeah, let's use Bob's head on this last one. I'm going to have to go back and watch the footage on that one, but I could have sworn I threw that up. Wait, does that thing bounce too because of my rubber tears? Or did I somehow hit down by mistake? I don't know. So, range down, speed up. It's always the first floor. Not sure what you mean, Private Steve. Okay, so here I can trade two bombs and get three, which is fortunate because I happen to have two bombs. Or are you talking about the boss, Privacy of the Haunt? The nice thing about doing the challenge is I'm not playing on hard mode. So, in that respect, it's a little bit easier than my recent playthroughs. I just got hit like a billion times by these things. All part of the plan. Okay, so I'm getting the map effect from the Liberty Cap, and it looks like there's some sort of mini-boss up here. So I will see what that's all about. Yeah, I don't mind the Haunt normally. He kind of kicked my ass in the last run. The Haunt always kicks my ass as Azazel or Azazel, because with such a short range, it's really hard to hit him without getting hit by him. Okay, gonna have to be very methodical to make sure I don't get overwhelmed by envy heads here. Gonna take my time, relax, take deep breaths, one head at a time. So far, so good. Crap. Gotten hit way too many times on this floor. I've got to be pretty close to death. I really hate not knowing how much health I have. I mean, not that it should matter, because I should play as carefully as possible all the time. But man, when you don't know how much health you have, you feel more invulnerable than you actually are. Hey, what's up, Levon15? Yeah, I would say definitely get this version over the original. This version's an improvement in just about every way, I think. I mean, some people might disagree, but I really don't see any reason to go back to vanilla Binding of Isaac or original Binding of Isaac. Isn't there another expansion for this game coming out soon? It seems nuts to me. Because the Wrath of the Lamb already added so much crap, and then this version of the game added so much more crap. Like, I thought Edmund McMillan said he was done with this game after, well, originally he said he was done with the game after Wrath of the Lamb came out, that there wouldn't be any more DLC. But, I guess all the millions of dollars he's made from this game has changed his mind a little bit. Actually, I wonder how well this game did compared to the original. Because, I mean, the original was cheap. I think it was like $5 or $6 even when it's not on sale. So, if everyone who bought the original bought this game, then this game is like 15. Well, you got a discount on this game if you owned the original Binding of Isaac, so I think I paid 10 for it. But even still, everyone who bought the original bought this version for $10. That's like double the money he made from the original. Yeah, darkness with the boss that causes darkness. It's a good thing the effects didn't stack. I wonder if I can do that challenge room now that I picked up those soul hearts. I might start doing like a chat room overlay when I play. Nope, still don't have enough. When I play Rebirth, because I mean, there's all that empty space on either side of the screen that, you know, a nice little chat window would probably fit in there pretty well. Shouldn't be too annoying for people who don't want to see it. I mean, I've been watching some PS4 streams recently, and those always had the chat on the right hand side, and it's easy enough to just ignore it, I think. Arcade, eh? Yeah, let's save my money for now, see if I can make enough money to buy something from the shop, since I have two keys. Man, my item selection has been pretty poor in both of these runs. If I could just avoid, getting hit for the first floor, then I could probably get a devil room and have much better odds for the remainder of the game. Just I always take a hit or two on the first floor, 'cause I suck. I've been much more liberal with the devil rooms than I usually am recently. I find that giving up hearts is usually worth it. For certain items, anyway. Dime, that's nice. Like, if I can, I'll normally try to get rid of all of my red hearts and just go with a soul heart run. Because I find that the items I get help, and having only soul hearts is pretty helpful in certain situations too. Like if you get the normal Polaroid once you beat Mom, rather than the negative, if all you have is soul hearts, then you get a short shield every time you get hit. So sacrificing a bunch of life to the devil and then getting the Polaroid is a pretty good strategy, I found. Crap, is that... It's not the cursed eye, because the cursed eye is just solid white. I think that's the eye in the back of my head. Oh, it's the triple shot. That's interesting. Well, with the bouncing effect, I should theoretically have a higher hit percentage. Possibly. Also, these spiders, very difficult to see with Curse of Darkness on. I wonder if I can even get the black handle on the challenge run. And if I can, I wonder if it even does anything. I'd say probably not. If I could just negate this challenge by picking up or buying an item, then that would be kind of lame. Or it would be kind of awesome, depending on how you look at it. Man, a lot of super mini bosses, super sins on this run. Don't see these that often. Nine lives. Black Candle used to negate it, now it doesn't. Darn. I'm not picking that up. I mean, it's... Crap, maybe I should. I don't know. Because another good thing about the Devil Rooms is if you can transform into Guppy, it's like an enormous help. Oh, you're playing the challenge along with me. Awesome. Good luck. Hope you do better than I am. Can you even... Yeah, it still has a seed. Huh. I wonder what happens if someone were to put that seed in, if it would be this exact dungeon, except... It doesn't always have the curse lawn, or I wonder how that would work. Yeah, I'm not picking that up. If I had better items, if I was doing better on this run overall, I might risk it. Just for the potential of later turning into Guppy, but if that's the only Guppy item I have, then it's not even a guaranteed thing, and yeah, not worth it. I'm making an executive decision regarding getting the 9 lives. Don't remember. Oh, yeah, that's like you get more. You get more of the. I don't know what they're called. Epic enemies, strong enemies, the colored versions of enemies, which since I'm not playing on hard, that might actually be kind of cool. But I'll stick with the Liberty Cap. Crap. Range down. Screw you. This looks like a pretty good spot to bomb. Tears up. Nice. Yeah, I want to hang on to the stars card. The Norwegian actor, Stellan Starsgard. He played the professor in the Thor movies. Get it. I'm so hilarious. Speaking of movies, I still haven't seen Mad Max. I've been wanting to. I just haven't really had the opportunity recently. I think it's still in theaters. I might still have a chance. The movie sounds pretty good. I did see the new Avengers movie. It was okay. I liked it about as much as the first Avengers movie. You know, they're fun, goofy comic book movies. I don't really expect that much out of them. But for what it was fine. Wait. Is there no shop? Did I already open it? Or Are there no shops on the challenge runs? On any of them? That's pretty lame, if that's the case. I don't think I've seen a single shop. Oh, god darn. I guess I can just throw all my money away on gambling. No shops on this one. So I guess it's just some of the challenges that don't have shops. I know some of the later challenges in the original game didn't have shops, but it's kind of crappy of them to do you that way right on the first challenge. Well, at least I can abuse this thing. I just have to be careful and not lose count of how many times I've used it. Oh, hey, Skettle. Nice. Oh, man, on this run, not having to deal with flies, that's amazing. See if I can get a few more hearts that I can pump into that blood machine. See if I can get a blood bag. Man, I'm pretty excited that I got that poop hat. Still have to deal with the spiders, the flashing spiders that are also super hard to see, but should make my life a little bit easier. So, Just Drop, do you know what that symbol means? Does that just mean that I haven't finished this challenge yet, or does that indicate something else? Nice. Hey, pretty fly. I'm certainly being generous with the money here. I don't want to spend too much time doing this, though, because I know that makes for super entertaining streaming, sitting here gambling all day. Alright, I won't push my luck. It means I can't earn achievements other than the challenge. Oh, okay, that makes sense. I'm doing pretty good with the achievements in this game. I have, the bump has an event starting. I have 135 out of 178, 75%. That's not bad. I have quite a ways to go. I want to see what you unlock for beating these challenges, because I know something really weird. I just don't know what they do. Alright, anything else on this floor? Nah, okay. If you play a seed, you get the same icon. Oh, really? So someone could put in this seed, and it takes them into the challenge? It's not just like this dungeon layout without the curses? It's kind of interesting. The Hollow. Nice. Well, why is it saying broadcasting is enabled? It's kind of odd. Hey, Devil Room, nice. Did someone start watching the broadcast? No. Weird. Oh, great! Of course it's Krampus. Why wouldn't it be? Feeling pretty good about my triple shot. I got my shot speed up to, oh crap, up to an acceptable level with that. Ah, man. I like the Krampus head, but it takes so freaking long to recharge. They play that seed, they'll get a normal run without obtaining any achievements. Oh, I see. Interesting. And I think I'll stick with Bob's head. I don't know, though. Bob's head is kind of meh. And I have a good number of bombs, yeah. I mean, I never pick up Krampus' head. Bob's head isn't that good. It's not worth passing up something interesting. Potentially interesting. Yeah, let's pop the stars card. Oh, nice! This should interact well with my triple shot. That's pretty good. Kind of hoping it'd be a little faster than that, but These beggars can't be choosy. Oh, hey, boss already. What Krampus' head is really good for are when you get like a double boss, or if you're fighting like the Fallen or something. If you can get between them and hit both of them with the blood lasers, that's a pretty significant amount of damage. Oh, hey, what's up, Cuss? Good to see ya. How's it going? Crap. Oh, hey. I'll save that rainbow poop for after this room. Oh, never mind. I'll activate it now, apparently. I guess that was one of my bouncy tears that did that, because I was deliberately trying not to hit that thing until I clear this room out. But who knows, maybe that just saved me from dying, because I have no idea how much health I actually had. Jesus. Okay. One more. Man, that was an annoying room. I keep forgetting I have the scatol. I probably didn't even have to worry about those poop piles. Playing Dota nonstop. Oh, be careful, Goss. It's not good for your health. You don't want to overdose. You don't want to overdose to Dota. That didn't work. You don't want to overdose on Dota. I wonder what determines whether those things' heads pop off or not. Hey, buddies. Wait. Aw, that still hurts me? Even when I had the poop hat, that sucks. Yeah, with those big guys, sometimes they just die, sometimes they die in stages. Probably sort of random. Alright, no secret room here because there's a gap on both sides. It's bad for your nerves. Yeah, bad for my nerves, and I don't even play. I just try to watch people when I get nervous. Crap. Well, let's see. Oops. Okay. You can use a bomb here and get the pill and the battery. Probably not worth using one on the other side. Not that I need the battery now, but I can come back for it. Great. Man, I miss the ability to play as Kane and just not have to worry about bad pills at all. That was the best thing ever. Of course, now I can play as Azazel and start with basically brimstone, which is pretty good. But if I could trade it for no bad pills, I don't know, that'd be tempting. I wonder if there's a mod. Like, is it even possible to mod this game? I don't know. Bad pills aren't that bad. They have bad right in the name, Cuss. Of course they're that bad. They wouldn't call them bad pills if they were good. I mean, yeah, they only affect you once, and they're not, they're not that bad. But still, like, if you're doing poorly, getting, like, tears down or something, it just rubs salt into the wound. Just makes it that much more frustrating. But I read the other day about someone who modded... Oops, why did I pick that up? Someone who modded Might and Magic Clash of Heroes. Damn it. And I didn't think that game was moddable, so I'm not sure how they did it. But I mean, there are people who do, like, weird challenges and stuff in this game, right? Or I know they did that with the original. I'm not sure how much of that was just, like, manipulating seeds, or if there was any, like, actual monkeying with the game itself involved, but I mean, my point is, I wonder if it would be possible to mod that back into this game. The no bad pills thing. Of course, I don't know how people could manipulate seeds in the original Binding of Isaac either. It did not seem to have any user accessible parts. I should probably be using this Krampus head because I have two batteries on this level. Might as well, you know, make the most out of them. Make the most of it, rather. This is a pretty good chest. Yeah, this area looks promising. Nope. Well, this other area looks promising. Let's do it this way just so I know I'm putting the bomb in exactly the right spot. Nope. Let's see what else looks promising. This room looks... Okay, I already tried that. Let's try this. Nice. Man, more batteries. It really wants me to be using the stupid Krampus head. Wait. Oh. Oh, right, it's that. Eh, I might as well get that half heart. I'm not hurting for bombs. And I probably need it. Not that I would know. Nice. Alright, I guess Krampus' head isn't that bad. No devil room. Let's go back for one of those batteries and get the heck out of here. What does Krampus' head do again? It's that quadruple laser thing. You probably asked that before I used it, so... I didn't need to explain that. Wait, why? There's no door into that room. Oh wait, that's a secret room. Duh. Oh, I wonder if my health is full now. Might as well look at the challenge room. There also haven't been any pain doors, it looks like. Is it worth it for... Well, I can get that other battery, so... Go on ahead and do that. Get rid of those annoying angel things. I mean, if you can combo the Krampus head with something that like recharges your items a lot faster, then it would actually be pretty amazing. But I'm never that fortunate. Shit! Well, at least I know my health is full since I was even able to make it in here in the first place. And I got a key out of it. Oh well. Let's pick up the other battery and get out. Oh. I should have placed the bomb here so I could get both that heart and that battery. But I didn't need it anyway, so oh well. Also, when it's dark like this, I can't see if there are any... blocks with the X on them that have goodies in them. Because the color palette is all screwy. They don't stand out like they normally do. Is that? Oh. So it's an ability... Oh, okay. So this is the one, I think, where I can fly around as a head... and my body walks around dealing damage to people. It's the same recharge as Krampus's head. I'm not sure if it's worth it. Played some Path of Exile recently. That's cool. I kinda like that game from what I played of it. I didn't like that you can't really do a full respec of your character. Or wait, you mean Pillars of Eternity? Because that's also a PoE game. Which I've heard mixed things about that game. Crap. God, this thing sucks. I can't go anywhere in this room. He said, exaggerating. Path of Exile. Yeah, like, the game seemed neat. It does a lot of cool things, but with that enormous, intimidating skill tree, I'd really like the ability to respect my character. Because I was playing as a witch, and I was focused on necromancy, so basically my big thing was reviving enemies and making them fight for me. And I was doing pretty well for a while, but eventually I just started really getting my ass handed to me, and I suspect that's because I wasn't speccing my character as optimally as possible. See if I can get this thing to break open this for me. Might not get close enough. Doesn't look like it. Ah, there we go. Wait, what's still in this room? Why are these things still shooting at me? Oh. Well, I couldn't see it, but it's dead now. Wish they made a mod for Binding of Isaac that brings back old music. Well, you could always mute the in-game music and play the soundtrack, like bring up a playlist on YouTube or something and listen to it that way. I know it's not exactly the same, but I like the music in this game. I like both soundtracks. They're both good in their own ways. I probably should have stuck with Krampus's head. I'm not 100% sure I'm even right about what these scissors do. I know they're the pinking shears that make you headless, basically give you the ability to fly around. But I think those have a faster recharge. Well, let's oops, wrong button. Okay, so this gets rid of my head floats around independently shooting at people, and my body does its own thing. Somehow my body is still crying of its own accord, even without a head. So wait. So my body still takes damage. I'm assuming my head is immune. At least it better be immune, since I can't control it or anything. I can't, like, move it around with the mouse, no. That'd be kinda cool. At what point did I start getting wrecked in Path of Exile with my build? I don't remember what level I was or anything. It's been a while since I played. I was kind of far into it. I think I was like level 10 or 11 or something like that, which I mean, in the grand scheme of things, probably isn't that much. But it feels like I played it for a good 4 or 5 hours before I started getting wrecked. I think if I was to play another game like that, I'd probably go back to like Torchlight 2 or something and play that again, but on a higher difficulty level or something. I really like a lot of things about Torchlight 2. I mean, I like a lot of things about Path of Exile as well, but it might be a little too hardcore for me. Yeah, I think I'm gonna go back for Krampus. I don't really like the scissors. Waiting at the trophy for me, well, damage just dropped. Of course, you have the advantage over me. You're not talking and explaining things as you play. And you're probably not obsessing over every little detail. Every little decision. There we go. That's pretty cool. Alright, well, let's turn all of my hearts into soul hearts. However many I have. Okay, apparently I had 5. So that was probably overkill. But now I'm full up on soul hearts, so let's see what this game has to offer. Was that a dumb decision? Probably. But I feel more confident. I don't know, for some reason I don't stress out about health as much when I know I have nothing but soul hearts. It only goes to the mom fight. Okay, that's cool. Can I say that again? I think I was level 10 or 11 in Path of Exile. I played for about 4 or 5 hours, I believe. And if I was going to play a game like that, I would probably go back to Torchlight 2. Okay. Well, I have one heart now. Well, let's see if this guy has anything for me. Nah. Alright, let's blow both these guys up. Well, shit. I had 14 keys. I should have given that guy some keys. Oh well. Yeah, I got the triple shot, and I got a tears up pill, but I haven't gotten any actual damage up yet. I don't think. You have one challenge left, Restrop? Nice. I have 19 left. And I think there's one challenge I haven't even unlocked yet. And I don't know how to unlock it. I'm probably going to have to look that up. Maybe it unlocks as you do some of the earlier challenges. I'm not sure. Famous last word in roguelikes. Yeah, I should never say I'm confident in this game. It's always a kiss of death for me in Binding of Isaac. As soon as you express confidence, that's when the game starts punishing you. So yeah, of the roguelikes I could be playing, I think this is probably the one I most want to spend my time with. Because I've pretty much done everything in Spelunky. And Ziggurat, I'd like to go back to Ziggurat, but it just runs really poorly on my computer when I stream it. And it's kind of a bummer, because that game's not as much fun when it's not, when the action isn't smooth. I don't know where the secret room is. I bombed all the obvious locations. Let's try a non-obvious location. Okay, it's not going to be down there. I don't... Wait. Is there a gap? Yeah, there's a gap there, so it's definitely not there. I don't know. Oh well. Screw it, let's fight a boss. Necropolis 2. Oh wait! Is this going to be Mom? I think it is. Yeah, Necropolis 2. Alright, well, I have plenty of health. I have Krampus's head. Let's do this. Nice. I could have waited until there were like multiple doors open and hit her from two directions, but I kind of wanted to make absolutely sure that I hit her with it. And these doors can kind of close suddenly and mess up your plans. Oh god. You suck, Mom. I should have streamed this game for Mother's Day. That would have made sense. Alright. Wait, it still gives me the item? That's weird. Because there's nothing else, right? Rune of Hagalaz. Nice. Alright, well, that could have gone a lot worse. Let's try one more challenge. Oops, wrong thing. Highbrow. I have no idea what this is going to be. This isn't going to be a super long stream. I'm probably going to quit here in about half an hour or so. So, let's just get a feel for what this challenge is. Okay, so I have the turdy touch, the disease. I have the pee power up. I have the poop trinket, the lucky poop, and I have the flusher. So I see what they mean when they say highbrow. Okay, nice. Oh, and I have poop bombs. Okay. Well, I should have gone in there first, so I don't lose my soul heart. Oh, well. Ah. I can see it's a miracle. I wonder if I'm going to start getting that rune, like, in the challenge. I hope so. I have no idea what it does. Yeah, definitely messed that up. Should have gone in there before I picked up the soul heart. I wasn't thinking. When did I start streaming? It was roughly 7:30-ish, I think. Wait, I can see right there. Yeah, it was almost exactly. Well, it was about 7:20. It was an hour and 6 minutes ago. So the flusher is actually pretty cool. I don't know if I've showed it off on stream before, but it turns every enemy in a room into poop. Like, I don't think it works on bosses. But if I'm like in a really annoying room where I have a ton of knights to deal with or some other enemy I hate, and just hit a button and they all become poop. When I first saw that, the flusher thing, I thought it was a crack pipe. Not that I know what a crack pipe looks like. I mean, not from first-hand experience or anything. Alright, check for secrets. So that makes my shots a little wider. I wonder if there's like more poop in this challenge run than there would be otherwise. Doesn't seem like it so far, but for the purposes of sticking to the theme, I'll hold on to the lucky poop. Alright, let's do it. I should just let this room fill up with flies and then just use my flusher. That'd be awesome. I think I'll do that. Also, I'm not 100% sure that it doesn't work on bosses. I mean, I assume it doesn't, but I haven't tested it. So let's see what happens. I wonder if there's a maximum number of flies that can be on the screen for this boss fight. Yeah, it looks like it's not spitting out anymore. Alright. So yeah, it doesn't do anything to the boss. But hey, with my lucky poop, that's actually a good combo. You can turn stuff into poop and then get goodies from it. Which is a video game ass sentence that I wish I didn't just have to say. But it's true. Now see, if one of these poops drops a battery, then you can kind of keep this combo going. Wait for the screen to build up with flies again and just keep it up. But I probably won't get that lucky. I need to do some damage to the Duke. He's effectively blocking me with his flies. I like how the challenge isn't really a challenge. Those are always the fun ones. Like the Dr. Fita challenge from the original game. It's the best challenge in the game. Nice. All stats up. I like that a lot. Man, look at how fast my stream is now. I don't bomb the marked rocks. Oh, I didn't see one. I mean, I... Oh, okay. Yep, I did not notice that. Thank you, Goss. Nice. I have 13 pennies, but I only have two. Well, let's see what's in here. Man, if I had two more, I could get the blue map. There's no donation box in the challenge room. I guess it would be unfair for me to draw from resources from the main game in a challenge run. So that makes sense. There's no money I missed anywhere, is there? Because I would totally buy that blue map if I could. Yeah, there's nothing on the map. Oh well. Maybe another day. Is there anything else I want in here? I could buy a pill. Yeah, why not? Nice! Alright, I like the way this challenge is going. So I said in my Castle in the Darkness stream that I was going to stream a card game last weekend, and I didn't get around to it, unfortunately. I had too much other stuff to do. I do still want to stream that game, because it's a pretty cool game. I plan to do it at some point. Definitely want to do more Castle in the Darkness this Sunday, though. I'm really enjoying that run. Like, that's a cool game to show off. I like the, I like exploring a world with you guys live on the stream. I mean, oh, it's a rune. Yes! Destruction. I don't know what that does. Does it make my bombs blow up bigger or something? No? Well, if I wasn't streaming, I'd probably just pull up the wiki and see what that says. It's a secret cost. I still haven't 100% decided if I want to stream it or not. But it's pretty cool. It is a card game that you play over the internet. There's a hint. Let's save my key for the actual item room. So yeah, I'll probably try to stream that next week at some point. I mean, you can play for free, so it'd be pretty cool if I could get some viewers in the stream to play along with me. So it's the sort of thing I'd want to announce, you know, well in advance. No, it's not Hearthstone. I promise I will not stream Hearthstone, because I am terrible at that game. Like, oh my god. I rage quit that game so hard. No, the game I want to play is not a collectible card game. There's another hint for you. Non-collectible. Okay. Let's bomb this. Hopefully that'll get the chest as well. Yeah, awesome. The game itself is terrible. I don't know. A lot of people enjoy it. Shit. Stop! Oh, God, I hate it when they do that. I keep thinking they'll just bounce off me and go off in the other direction. But no, they freaking do the pincer attack on me. Wait, is there no item room? Well, isn't that a load of crap? Okay, so maybe this is a challenge. I guess now that I think of it, there wasn't an item room in the last one either. Oh wait, I have to use that room. That's in the same slot as the card or the pill, right? So I have to actually use that to see what it does. Okay, I'll do that against the boss. I'll get the candle. I mean, it might work on this challenge run. I mean, since a curse isn't the theme of this challenge, hopefully that means a black candle will work. Yeah, there's no item room privacy. That sucks. I would have gone in the double locked, the room with two locks over there, but I only have one key. So, oh well. Okay, so let's kill the little haunts, and then once the big haunt is active, we'll see what Hagalaz does. Crap. I have literally never used a rune before. This is a first, a world first. All right. It blew up the rocks, and it made a spider appear. But there's probably just a spider, or maybe it was a pot. Okay. Well, that's potentially kind of cool. I don't know. Could be useful. I mean, since this is the first challenge, I don't expect amazing things from it, but that's not worth spending a heart on. I will pick those up, though. Alright, let's see. That looks like a good spot for a secret. Yes. Okay. Double return on my investment, I'll take it. You start with four items or something, so not having item rooms isn't that bad. Yeah, that's true. I mean, they're not the best items in the world that you start with, but it's not, it doesn't make this challenge extremely difficult, there not being any item rooms. Oh, I don't know what the missing poster does. I looked it up at one point, but I forgot. I think I want to hang on to the petrified poop. This is probably going to set the world record, or break my personal record, for number of times I say poop in one stream. Which I guess is the point of the challenge. Oh, I hate these things. You go away now. Yeah. That's what you do. Apparently, you're way more likely to get the super version of the sins when you do a challenge. Every time I fought one of those, it's been the super version of it. Or it could just be a big coincidence. Right, let's use a bomb here. I'm still doing really good on health so far. Sure. Get a chest. Didn't get any soul hearts from that. From those fires, but that's okay. And there's nothing in the chest, so this whole thing was pointless. I just wasted a soul heart and a bomb. But I ain't mad. Open sesame. And see, this thing's already recharged. Wow, that seems faster. Oh, okay, I must have the battery, because when I use it, it already has a charge. So that's cool. Apparently you start with the battery on this run. Wonder if I have something else that makes it charge faster. No. Just one from a room. I mean, I guess, basically, the battery is just, it's giving me the charge that I would have gotten from the room I use it in, because since all the enemies become, or wait, maybe that's what's happening. When I use it, all the enemies die, and I just immediately get the charge for it. Okay, so there's a shop. Oh wait, there's a shop. I knew there's a shop. There's no item room in this one. Think with your brain, Duke. Valve started selling their controllers. Yeah. I don't know what to think about those. I mean, it doesn't look comfortable to use, but it's Valve, so they probably know what they're doing. I'll wait and see what people who review the controller have to say. I mean, they're like $50, so I probably won't pick one up unless it's pretty good. If I was going to spend $50 on a controller, to be honest, I'd probably want to buy an Xbox controller, because it's obnoxious having to deal with games that only support Xbox controllers. And it'd be a lot nicer to just not have to worry about it. Like, I've been considering buying an Xbox One controller, but I don't think they necessarily, like, they're not as plug and play as the Xbox 360 controller is. Because I really dislike the 360 controller. The Xbox One controller looks pretty nice, but if I have to mess with a bunch of shit to get it to work, then I'll just stick with my PlayStation 2 DualShock 2 controller. There's a video with Tommy Refines saying they're good. Refines? Refines? It's one of the Team Meat people. Okay, I guess I'm done here. Aw, man, not Gertie. Not the hurdy-gurdy, man. Man, the hurdy-gurdy is such a cool instrument. Like, there was a period a few months ago where I got really into watching people play the hurdy-gurdy on YouTube. It's possible to play the instrument really badly, but there are some really awesome hurdy-gurdy players on YouTube. It's like the dumbest instrument ever. It costs like $2,000, and it's super nerdy, but I like it. Evil range and shot speed. Oh, that's cool. And no item. Oh, Guppy's collar. It's better than nothing. What? That's dumb. I didn't even see that thing. The Waka Waka Challenge. Single lanes. Oh, okay. Holy crap. That sounds like a nightmare just dropped. I don't know what the Waka Waka Challenge is, but everything else you said sounds pretty horrible. Is a Waka Waka Challenge just the game trolling you as much as possible? You don't see these that often. The bombable doors. Oh yeah. So, what's the deal with these rooms? Like, there's a hidden passage, like, under this rug, but you have to be able to bomb it, right? I think the bombable door always has a bedroom in it, so I should have thought that through, but I saw something unusual and I just wanted to check it out. That's a very rare occurrence, seeing the bedroom. Like, even without the Curse of Darkness, those things are super hard to see in this room. Magnetic tears plus the ones that don't fire until you release the button. So basically it pulls enemies towards you. Oh my god. That sounds super obnoxious. What number challenge is that just dropped? Because I want to know how much longer I have until I have to deal with that shit. Shit. 7 or 17. I'm hoping it's 17. Because if it's 7, that means it's gonna happen relatively soon. Alright, so if I just pick up another bomb, I'm gonna try bombing the rug in the bedroom. Because I'm pretty sure it always leads to a black market. Or whatever it's called in this game. I think it's called the Black Market. The underground market. Alright, see you later, just drop. Okay. Made it to the boss. It'd be really cool if I could get another bomb. Oh man. If I had one, I could trade it for three. But I don't even have one. I don't have a single bomb to my name. Of course, if I had one, I could have already gone to the black market. So I wonder what happens if you're doing a challenge where you only have to go, you only have to fight Mom. You can't go further down into the dungeon than Mom. I wonder what happens if you do that, but you have like the shovel or a black market or something that lets you bypass the boss of that level. Like I wonder if you just automatically beat the challenge or if you just screw yourself out of being able to beat the challenge if you do that. Hopefully I won't be able to test it, because yeah, this is just Catacombs 2, I'm not close to Mom yet. It's an interesting thought though. Alright, there's a shop there, so hopefully I'll be able to buy a bomb. I mean, not that I'll be able to buy anything from the black market, but I think they have some free items as well, usually, don't they? Or no, the black market is you trade hearts for stuff, right? It's like a devil room, except that you're trading hearts from normal items instead of devil items. So, potentially not great, but I kind of want to check it out anyway. Oh, agreed. The one time I actually want a shop. That's not true. I always want a shop. I never want to have to fight greed. Oh, he gave me bombs though, so I can't complain too much. So yeah, bomb the rug, look for secrets, fight the boss. That is the plan of action. Loot! I mean, you think I could just move the rug? Oh! Okay, it's one of these. Well, the spider butt is not better than the flesh in this situation. I don't think. I went ahead and use it though. Oh wait, no, that it doesn't spawn spiders, it just slows enemies down. Yeah, I'll hang on to the flesh. So I guess this is not always a black market. I kind of thought it was. Alright, well I only have one bomb, so let's go for the most likely spot, which is this. Yeah. Playing the odds pays off yet again. The Wretched. I couldn't let it spawn a bunch of spiders and turn them all into poop. It's gonna stomp its own spiders to death anyway. Not really worth trying, I guess. Damn it! Nice! Man, my tears are my attack is pretty formidable now. Ooh, pentagram, that's nice. I think. Yeah, I'll take it. Damage up. I was probably thinking of the Abaddon, or Abaddon, whatever. It's another thing that's shaped like a pentagram. But it's way more awesome than the actual pentagram. But that's still a pretty good trade-off, one health for more damage. My damage is super high now. And my tears are tremendous. Yeah, that's worth it. Nope. Could have been worth it, but it wasn't. I should stop saying worth it until I find out whether it's actually worth it or not. Flush! Nice. I could have killed those things, but I need to start using the same more often. And speaking of games with good Danny B soundtracks, how about that Crypt of the Necrodancer? I haven't bought it yet, but I really want to. It looks like a pretty good time. I go on YouTube and listen to the shopkeeper sing in that game regularly. Grim Dawn from the devs of Titan Quest. Titan Quest was sort of Diablo-like, wasn't it? I think I remember that game. There was like a 2006-2007 game, I think. It's like Diablo with ancient Greek mythology, or possibly ancient Roman mythology. Aw, man. I wish I had my flush. I might just come back here after I get my flush. Oh, yeah. I forgot that my bombs make everyone all woozy. See, I don't really think of games like Diablo as action RPGs. I don't know, I guess they technically are, but when I think of an action RPG, I think of something like, I don't know, Dark Souls or The Witcher, something where, you know, you're swinging a weapon and dodging and stuff. Like, Titan Quest and Path of Exile and stuff, I just think of those as Diablo-likes. Which, I guess I'm being pedantic, because I mean, there's much action games as, like, well, I was going to compare it to, like, Dota or League of Legends or something, but I guess people don't really consider those action games, even though they kind of are. I thought that was a term for those games. Yeah, you're right, but I don't know. I mean, if someone says, hey, you should play this awesome action RPG, what I picture in my mind is, like, a third-person view of your character from behind the back, and you're kind of moving around, you know, directly rather than clicking, and you know, they go to wherever your mouse cursor is pointing. I mean, it's still action, I guess. Like I said, I'm just being pedantic. Yeah, I'll use that. Get a couple keys. I never save my two of clubs or two of spades cards. I probably should. I bet the reason I'm seeing stuff like the bedroom and the rainbow poop that I haven't seen in a while is because I've been playing on hard. And I bet that stuff just doesn't show up on hard. Witcher 3 is action RPG. Combat isn't turn-based. Yeah, but, I mean, like, would you consider Diablo an action RPG just drop? Or am I the only one who's being weird about this? Hey, Pandora's Box. That's pretty cool. I'm going to use that now. I knew it would do that. No, I didn't. I found pills, okay. And recharge my flush. And buy a bomb. Why not? There is no arena. Well, I mean, the arena is kind of like the map that you always play on in those games. I don't know. I think people should call Dota and League of Legends FARTS. F-A-R-T-S. It stands for Fast Action Real-Time Strategy. If I was in charge, that's what everyone would be calling them instead of MOBAs. Because it's a much more accurate description of them, I think. Ooh, Because it's like a real-time strategy game, but much more action-oriented. Diablo isn't really about positioning. Yeah, well, okay. What I consider an action RPG is you have direct control over your character. So, like, even Kingdom Hearts with it would be called an action RPG more so than Diablo. Because you have direct control over your character and you push a button and it attacks. Of course, I guess if you play Diablo with a controller, you do have direct control over it, so... So I guess I'm just really splitting hairs here. I don't know. I'm dumb. Don't listen to me. I want to call the game genre farts. My opinion is invalid. But it's so perfect. Fast action, real-time strategy. I didn't come up with that, by the way. Someone on Twitter came up with that. It's not really a strategy game. You don't build a base, you just control one character plus minions. Yeah, but it's based on a strategy game, damn it. Uh-oh, I was going to use my flush on the adversary, but didn't do anything. Oh well. I got rid of those spiders. That'll show them. I would still consider Dota a real-time strategy game. Just because there's no bases doesn't mean it's not real-time strategy. But you know, debating game genres is like the most boring thing in the world. I should not have brought it up. Oh my god. Man, I wish I still had my D6. I'd be rerolling all kinds of these items. And every video game can be called a strategy game, including Binding of Isaac. Well, I mean, the strategy in League of Legends or Dota is coordinating with your teammates. That's where the strategy comes from. In Binding of Isaac, there's no coordinating with your teammates. It's all action. But yeah. Yeah, Kingdom Hearts is an action RPG, exactly, just dropped. Like, but when people think action RPG, I don't know if they would think of Kingdom Hearts. They might think of Diablo. I don't know. Let's just call everything a shooting game. Because that's what it all is when it comes right down to it. Mega Man's a shooting game, Binding of Isaac is a shooting game, R-Type is a shooting game, Doom is a shooting game. I think I might have said Doom already. Call of Duty is a shooting game. Let's see. Am I feeling confident enough to use the Blood Machine? Counter-Strike is a strategy game. I mean, kinda. You're strategizing with your teammates. I don't know. Don't listen to me. I'm just a confused old man. I turned 30 yesterday, so I am officially an old man now. And I'm always confused, so that hasn't changed. Oh hey! I remember this thing being pretty good. Don't remember exactly what it does. I think I have a chance to spawn soul hearts when I get hit. Which, if that's the case, that's kind of cool. Do I want to take a point of damage to get this chest? Yeah. Oh hey! I'm not actually going to use that, but it's another guppy piece. I have the collar and I got the head, so just one more guppy piece and I turn into guppy, but this is the last level. Thank you, Koss. Oh, you know, I don't make a big deal out of my birthday, but I appreciate it. Wonder if my flesh would work on those big poops. When I post this video to YouTube, I just need to have a counter in the bottom right-hand corner of the screen that just goes up every time I say poop. Cause it's gotta be like 50 by now, right? Okay. Wasn't sure that would work on a mini-boss, but I wanted to try. Also, my theory about all of the Sin bosses being the super version is not valid, because that's just a normal sloth. The hermit, let's see. Well, since there's no item shop, that won't take me anywhere, right? Yeah. It's probably just a random teleport. Yeah, that's a good idea, Just Drop. He says, they should have put a poop counter in the game that uploads how many poops people have destroyed. And as soon as everyone who plays the game destroys a billion poops collectively, that's when the next expansion unlocks. That's probably way too many. Alright, better pills. I'll take that. And I'll take that. Tears up. Nice. Range up, thank you. I could buy the portable slot and put my last 7 coins into that. I think I'm okay though. This run's almost finished. I feel pretty good. Man, after playing on hard, these challenges are not as challenging as one might think. Just because I'm used to something way harder. Guild Wars 2 and Critters. I know in the... like, in the new Mortal Kombat game, there's like some sort of weird faction thing where like, you join a faction when you start playing the game, and based on how many people of that faction win matches that day, like... I mean, I don't think it actually does anything in the game, it's just like, bragging rights for that faction. But like, Abyss Odyssey tried to do something like that, where collectively, the more times people killed the final boss, as they killed the final boss, stuff was supposed to unlock. I didn't really follow that game closely enough to see what actually unlocked, though. I know there are more bosses and stuff, because I did have all the achievements in that game, but then an update came out and now I'm missing one achievement from it. Damn you, Abyss Odyssey. I have 2 perfect games now, though. I have Spelunky and Castle in the Darkness. And I'm really close to 100%ing the achievements for Shovel Knight. I just have to do the speedrun thing. Which, from what I understand, isn't as hard as you might think. I might go back and do that someday. But that would be 3 perfect games on my Steam account. Which means absolutely nothing. But I feel good about it for some reason. Just, you know, that lizard part of my brain just likes seeing all of those things filled in. Excellent. Rune of Jera. Crusader Kings 2, I think, costs. Alright, well, this has been the first 2 Binding of Ice Rebirth challenges. Still have quite a few to go, and I have 1 that I need to unlock. So I will see what I have to do to unlock number 11. But we still have a while before we get there. Alright, thanks to everyone who watched. It was a lot of fun. I'm going to try to do a stream on Sunday to play Castle in the Darkness. Hopefully that should happen, and then sometime next week I should post an announcement regarding the card game, the non-collectible card game, for anyone who wants to hang out and play. So yeah, you guys are awesome, and I will see you soon. Goodbye.